What's up everyone, Mainely Hockey Cards here, and I want to go over a lot I recently purchased on eBay that was probably scrolled over by thousands of people without a second thought, who ended up losing out big because they wouldn't look past the first image or title. The first image isn't that appealing with early 90s rookies. However, they are kept in card savers, which is always a good sign, so it gave me a sense that whoever had this collection took good care of it. Moving on to the description, it doesn't give much information, but it appears that the seller isn't well versed in hockey, so maybe there is something redeeming about the lot that would make it worth a bid or two. In the second picture, there isn't much. Until I notice in the bottom left corner this Jágr card. This is the first year of Prism Hockey, from 2012-13. This is also a Father's Day Pulsar Prism Parallel. Both the set and Jaromir Jágr are very collectible, so this really piques my interest. Knowing the general value range of these cards, the price I'm willing to pay for the lot immediately goes up to about $25 to $30 plus shipping. And I know I can make at least a 25% profit on the lot at this point. Pictures 3 and 4 don't show much. Picture 5, however, is a different story. Which one of these cards is the odd one out? I'll give you a second. It's the Quinn Hughes Allure rookie in the bottom right. Not only is it just a rookie, it's the Steel Parallel, which is numbered to only 60. At this point, after thinking about it, my max bid goes to about $50, and I feel I could make about a 30 to 40% profit on the lot, assuming these are the only two cards of value. On any given purchase, my goal is to make at least a 25 to 30% profit. I ended up winning the lot with a winning bid of $32.55 and total amount owed of $49.84. When I got the lot in, the Jágr and Hughes were the only two cards of value. There were some early 90s rookies, some supplies, and some storage boxes, but the combined values of those aren't worth mentioning. Essentially, each card cost only $24.92. So, we're 1 month later. What did I sell them for? The Jágr netted me $58.85, which was enough to cover the lot and then some. The Hughes netted me $44.18. Combined, $103.03 for both, or approximately 106% profit on my initial investment. This video isn't meant to be a brag, because for every stud lot like this, there are plenty of duds. But it is a video to show how I operate, as well as give some insight to others on looking far beyond just their initial organic impression of a lot. Sometimes, these are the items that may not seem to have much face value, but might just be worth a thorough investigation. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and a little glimpse of how I do business. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like and consider subscribing. It's free, and you can always change your mind. Cheers, everyone.